Hello students, welcome to this video lecture. In this video lecture, we know the statement, proof and direct consequences of Green's theorem. First, let us we know the actual statement of Green's theorem. Green's theorem states that if p of x comma y and q of x comma y be two continuous functions having continuous partial derivatives in a region R of the xy plane bounded by a simple closed curve C, then integral along the closed curve p dx plus q dy is always equal to double integral over the region R dou q by dou x minus dou p by dou y into dx dy. It means that Green's theorem states only when two functions having continuous partial derivatives. Now let us know the proof of Green's theorem. Here, suppose if we shall consider the region R of the xy plane bounded by a closed curve. See, look at here in the diagram, x-axis, y-axis, the closed region, that is in the circle shape, this is the closed region R where C is having two curves C1 and C2. If we draw any two lines parallel to x-axis or either y-axis, they meet the curve C in at most two points. If we draw two parallel lines to x-axis, they meet the closed region at the points P and Q. Similarly, if we draw two parallel lines, that is x is equal to A, x is equal to B, these two parallel lines meet the closed region R at the points A and B. Let the region R bounded between the lines x is equal to A, x is equal to B, y is equal to C and y is equal to D as shown in the figure. Further, let us assume that the curve C is made up of two curves APB and BQA. Just now we see that the closed curve is closed with two curves C1 and C2. C1 is APB is C1 and BQA is C2. Let its equation be equation of those curves, that is C1 and C2, is y is equal to f1x is the equation of curve C1 and y is equal to f2x be the equation of the curve C2. Now we have integral, double integral dou p by dou y dx dy is equal to x, double integral x varies from 0 a to b and y varies from f1x to f2 of x dou p by dou y dy dx. If we integrate first, we get integral from a to b p of x comma y with limits f1x to f2x into dx. If we apply the limits f2x and f1x, we get integral from a to b p of x comma f2 minus p of x comma f1 dx. If I apply the limits, we get integral from a to b p of x f1 dx minus a to b p of x to x f2 dx. Now this can also be written as minus integral from a to b p of x f1x dx minus b to a p of x to x f2 dx, or simply we write integral along c1 pxy dx plus integral along the curve c2 pxy dx. Simply we write this as minus of integral along the closed curve c pxy dx or integral along the closed curve cp dx. Thus we get integral along the closed curve C p dx is always equal to minus of double integral dou p by dou y dx dy. Let we take this as equation number 1. Now let us assume that the curve is made up of two curves QAP and BQA. PBQ denoted by C1 and C2, its equations are x is equal to g1y and x is equal to g2y respectively. Thus, we have integral over the region R, double integral over the region R, dou q by dou x dx dy can be written as integral from y to C, y from C to D and x from g1y to g2y dou q dou by dou x dy dx. If we integrate this one, we get simply C integral from C to D q of xy g1y to g2y. Again, if I apply the limits, we get this integral from C to D q of g2y minus q of g1y. If we again we integrate and simplify, we get integral along C1 q xy dy plus integral along C2 q of xy dy, which is equal to integral along the closed curve q of xy dy and integral along the closed curve C q dy. Thus, we have integral along the C closed qy dy. Q dy is equal to double integral over the region R dou q by dou x dx dy. Let me take this as equation number 2. If we add equation number 1 and 2, we get integral along the closed curve C pdx plus q dy is equal to double integral over the double integral dou q by dou x minus dou p by dou y dx dy. Hence the theorem. This is the actual proof of Green's theorem. Let me know the consequences of Green's theorem or notes related to Green's theorem. Green's theorem gives us a relation between the plane surface integral and the line integral. This Green's theorem gives the relation between surface integral and line integral. The Green's theorem in vector form is given by integral along the closed curve C f dot dr is equal to double integral over the region R del dot f dot k dx. Let f is equal to pi plus qj be irrotational in the region R of the xy plane. You know what is the condition for irrotational? Irrotational means curl of f is equal to 0. Therefore, if curl of f or del cross f is equal to 0, then integral along the closed curve C f dot dr is equal to 0. Which implies the work done by the force F in displacing a particle round the closed curve C is always equal to 0. Which implies F is conservative. Supposing F is conservative force in xy plane, then there exists a scalar point function phi such that F is equal to del phi or del cross F is equal to del cross del F, which is equal to 0, which implies integral closed curve f dot dr is equal to 0. Conversely, if integral along the closed curve f dot dr is equal to 0, then we say that f is conservative. Thus, in xy plane, the circulation of f around a closed path vanishes if and only if f is a conservative force. The last one is the Green's theorem can be extended to a plane region which can be divided into finite number of subregions such that the boundary of each is met in at most 2 points by line parallel to either axis. This can be done by applying the theorem to each and adding the result. Okay, thank you.